We got a new leak related to the DualSense courtesy of a recent post on Reddit. Apparently, this user has had hands-on access with the DualSense as they uploaded a video showing the front and the back of the controller. What's more important though is some of the info they shared regarding the experience with it. Apparently, DualSense battery may last up to 4 hours longer than DualShock 4, which means it probably lasts 5 hours in total. Just messing around, but I'm happy if that ends up being true as the battery on the DualShock 4 sucks. The touchpad is now more responsible and clicky, which is a departure from the muddy feeling touchpad on the DualShock 4, and the light bar was replaced by a smaller and dimmer light strip, which means it probably won't work with the PSVR. They also mentioned both the R1 and R1 buttons now act more like triggers, requiring a movement similar to what you'd have with the L2 and R2, which I find very interesting and got me wondering why the change. Speaking of which, L2 and R2 are both now harder to push down, even without the controller making use of the adaptive feature. Now, before we jump to conclusions, there's still a chance that these buttons may loosen up a bit while in use as a result of the adaptive trigger feature being active in the game, so it's early to tell whether that's a good or bad thing. The user hasn't been able to test out the haptic feedback or the microphone, and that's understandable since there are no PS5 games out yet that make use of the feature aside from the Astrobot demo showcase that's going to be bundled with every PS5, and that might indicate that this person doesn't have access to the console itself or at least a development kit. That's all I have for now. Things are getting a lot more interesting as we approach the release of the new consoles, and if anything new crops up, I'll make sure to talk about it on the channel. Hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I'll talk to you on the next one. Bye.